Hello friends, in the last video, in the previous video, we have came across the introduction of the dart. Now let us go little in depth to the subject. This is very important question in dart, which is analysis of the algorithm, which is also known as algorithm specification, which is also known as pseudocode convention. Okay, the first pseudocode convention means the rules of, these are nothing but the rules of algorithm. The first rule is algorithm comments should begin with this symbol, and then we have to continue till the end of the line. Means if this is the comment which we wrote here, we should write like this. Here also we should write like this, like these lines should continue till the end of the line of comments, comment lines. Now the block should begin with opening flower braces and it should end with closing flower braces. Like if there are compound statements, means if there are multiple statements in the same program or algorithm, then we have to use opening and closing flower braces for starting and end of the statements. The third one is identifier begins with a letter and the data types are not explicitly declared. Means here the algorithm the identifiers begins with a letter. Letter means alphabetic order, and they are need not be explicitly declared. Compound data types can be formed with records. Compound means multiple data types can also be formed like this. These are only called multiple data types. Okay. Next, for assignment of values to variables, we are using the assignment operation. It is similar to other languages. We here also we have assignment operator, and for assignment operator we are using dot equal to, like this two dots and equal to. This is called assignment operator. See, here we are assigning the value 10 to the variable a. This is called assignment operator. And here also we have two boolean values which are called t or f, that is true or false. In order to produce these boolean values, we are using the relational operators. There are many relational operators: less than or equal to, greater than or equal to, and not equal to. These are relational operators. And in order to produce the boolean values, we also use logical operators. Logical operators are nothing but logical and, logical or logical not. Multidimensional arrays are represented within square brackets. And in order to represent the ith row and jth column of the multidimensional array, we represent as A of, this is called of, A of I, j, where A is an array, multidimensional array. I is the ith row of the multidimensional array A, and J is the jth column of the array A. Okay. Now coming to looping statements. These are all nothing but the rules of the, or the pseudocode conventions of the DA. Okay. Now coming to looping statements. This is the for loop format. For variable is equal to assignment of value 1 to n, means for the variable we are assigning 1 to n values and doing step by step by executing the statements. And this is while condition we are doing the statements. Do while means, do while means while this condition we are doing the statements. Okay. Now repeat until means we are repeating these statements until this condition is true. This is also known, this is only known as repeat until. Like we are repeating all the statements, like we are executing all the statements until the condition is true. Once it becomes false, then it will come out of the loop. Case statements. This is the eighth rule of pseudocode conventions. Eighth rule is case statements. Case statements are nothing but switch case. Means If condition 1 is true, statement 2 is executed. If condition 2 is true, statement 3 is executed. So on up to statement n. Like if condition n is true, then statement n is executed. Else it will come out of the loop and it it executes the default statement. Okay, and the 9th rule is output and input, that is input and output are done using the instructions. Like for input we use read, for output of the algorithm we use write. If you want to give the input to the algorithm, we are giving read operation, and if you want the computer or the system to give the output to you, then you have to use the write algorithm, like write command in the algorithm. Okay, and there is only one procedure and every algorithm should be in the same procedure. Like you can't write the algorithm as you wish, you should follow the particular procedure. This is the procedure of the algorithm: algorithm, algorithm name, and the parameter list, statements, body. Algorithm, you have to mention the name of the algorithm. Like if I am writing quicksort algorithm, I have to mention here quicksort. Okay, no need to write in full form, you can denote it as QS also, but in this place you have to write the quicksort algorithm, like the name of the algorithm, and whatever parameters I use in the algorithm I have to mention here. Like if it is some ABC, A comma B comma C, those are the parameters which are been used in this algorithm, so that I have to mention here, and these are the statements body. Okay, see friends, this is the example for selection sort algorithm. Algorithm name, selection sort I have named as cell sort, and these are the parameters which I used, and these are the comments. These are nothing but the comments. See, I have written the comments two lines, so I have extended the two lines to the extended the comment symbol to second line also, because the comment is not just a single line, it is multi-lined, it is like two lines, so I extended it. This is example of for loop. For I is equal to 1 to n, this selection sort using for loop. This is the program. Okay. Thank you friends, please do subscribe to my video. Thank you so much.